Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen of the press. It is indeed an honor, really truly an honor for me to bring home a beautiful young lady who's so proud of India. I must say I do feel a little bit like coming home because I've had such great experiences with the previous Miss Worlds. As you know, Rita Freya, it was quite a few years back, but she came, she won, then she stayed in India, from India to King's College in London, and she finished off her training as a doctor. She then married a wonderful Irish doctor, fell in love, and they went to live in Ireland. But she was always sweet, kind, and helpful. I know she's a great golfer now, but she always made a big impact on the world. And at that time, it was difficult for travel, and it was difficult with finance, but she managed it with great dignity. Of course, Aishwarya Rai is still like my baby. I know it sounds silly, but she was always giggly and happy, and she was a great delight to work with for the year. And of course, she's now happily married, and still her heart is with us when we need help. Priyanka, of course, again, entered by appearing in our show and being a real good support. And whenever we've needed help from any of them, they've all been ready to say, sure, what do you want us to do? So now we have the most beautiful, beautiful young lady. I'm so proud that we're able to work together for the year. I know that her belief, which of course she will tell you about, with all of us together, including you, we can make a huge difference across not just India, but across the world with her projects. There's two that she believes passionately in, and I know that several women around the world that were in this show this year, in Miss World, were still very, very focused on a similar project. So we're hoping to combine across the world a big, forceful awareness that women are fantastic, so are the guys, and that guys and girls are both special. But sometimes there's little changes that we all need to understand in each other. So if we start that from a school age, it won't be such a shocking experience for later. And this is something we can all do together. The other thing, of course, is her competence in medical studies and wishing to do things a lot more for youth here and people who have not the fortune of being helped with heart surgery of different kinds. And this is something that we passionately believe in. And I know we've been involved personally as president of Variety many years ago in bringing certain people together in the heart surgery world. We can do more of that too. We can also do more with your wonderful Indian fashion by taking Miss World across the world to do our projects and also to bring Indian fashion, put on fashion shows, raise the money in the areas. The great thing with Miss World, when we raise money, everything goes. We don't take anything from it. We started Beauty with a Purpose. That's why we called it that, because other charities take quite a big percentage. We decided that we would work and give all the money, and it was all there for everyone to see. So I'm so proud to be here. Thank you for the warmth you showed me at the airport. I saw the way you love her, and I loved you more for it because you're like a big family. When it comes to celebration, there's nothing better than an Indian celebration. And you celebrated at the airport, and everywhere we've gone, there was big smiles and pride. And isn't it good to have a country where everyone is proud of something? We need good news around the world, and this is great news. So thank you for listening to me. I hope that we can all work together and keep support for our beautiful young winner and just help her over the period of everyone saying, do you think you can? The answer is she will always do what she says she'll do, and she's got the support of all the world behind her. Thank you very much. Would you want
to go? Mrs. Julia Morley, I would request you to please take a seat. Thank you so much for this. We really, really appreciate. Right. That's indeed the plan. And thank you so much for making your presence felt. You have no idea how much we love you. And you have given our country so much progression. It is unbelievable. Thank you so much for that. Ladies and gentlemen, now it's the time to get... Ooh. Manashi, our Miss World, can you please say a few words before we open the forum for the Q&A? Please go ahead, and then you can take a seat. Thanks.
Good afternoon, everyone. Firstly, thank you so much for coming over here. And all I want to say is that I'd like to quote our former Miss World 2014, Rolene Strauss. Dr. Rolene Strauss, that we're all just like books. We all have our covers, but our stories are what make the difference. And I think that's what Miss World stands for. We're all young women who want to make a difference in the world, and we're all brought together at with this family of Miss World, where we could walk together in purpose. Though there would only be one winner at the end of the journey, but I think everyone has so much to learn, everyone has so much to offer. And, well, we know that whenever we visit any country, we know that we have one girl over there with an amazing project which we can take forward. When I was at Miss World, I think because I carried with myself so much of love and so much of support that I got from my country, so thank you so much, India, for giving that to me. And that gave me the confidence to stand on stage and lift my head with pride every time someone said, India. So thank you so much for coming over here.
Manushi, would you like to take some pictures, media, right now? Okay, Manushi, if you could step forward for some more pictures before you take a seat. Yes, sir.
Tanushi, congratulations on your win and for making India proud.
Hi, thank you so much.
Okay. I'm Shilpa from CNN News 18.
Hi, Shilpa.
I think we're all very interested in knowing if you plan on completing your studies or if you're going to be taking a break from it.
Well, I did take a year's break when I was crowned Miss India because I wanted to give my 100% to Miss World. But of course, I'll be completing my studies.
Oh, all right. That's great to know. Thank you, Manushi.
Thank you.
Hi, Manushi.
Hi.
Yeah.
Hi.
I'm Pooja Saman, journalist. Heartiest congratulations to you. You are really proud of all Indians.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
We would like to know what were the most challenging moments in your entire journey?
The most challenging moments at Miss World? To be honest, I cannot remember a very challenging moment at Miss World because everyone was so supportive over there, you know. And because you're traveling an entire country, we were traveling China together. And though many times we couldn't understand each other's languages, but because we were all so similar and there's a saying that strong women support each other, I think that is what we did through Miss World. And we never let each other ever hit a low. So there wasn't like one challenging moment that I could remember.
Hi, Manushi, Tushar this side. First of all, congratulations for making all of us proud.
Thank you so much.
My question to you is, what was the reason behind the Beauty with Mission? Like you adopted 20 villages. What did one thing come to your mind while doing this and what was the reason behind it?
Well, to be honest, when I started this project, before that, I had a lot of instances where I realized that there's not only a lack of awareness in our country when it comes to menstrual hygiene, but also the inaccessibility to sanitary pads. My domestic help, when I was a kid, she couldn't conceive, and that led her to marry thrice. And eventually she went into depression. So when my parents looked into it, we went to doctors to help her, and we realized that she had fibrous tissue in her uterus, and that was due to some infection she might have caught during her childhood. So these are very basic practices when it comes to menstrual hygiene, but they have a huge impact. And that's when I realized that there is a need of awareness. But 1 year in medical college, which is in rural Haryana, my medical college is in rural India. I realized that it's not just education, but we need to provide them with a sustainable system where they can practice menstrual management.
Hi, Manushi. Priyanka here.
Hi.
Hi. So, would you be becoming a doctor before becoming an actor or after? Because you're a doctor.
So, when I entered medical college, there was a joke my father told me that doctor actually translates to actor because you, irrespective of how, you know, how difficult the situation might be, you need to make sure that the patient is comfortable. You need to make sure that the patient feels good about the treatment. So I'm doing both.
Hi, Manushi. Manisha here from TIN.
Hi, Manisha.
Hi. I just wanted to know, so what are your plans now, further plans? And so Bollywood calling soon now?
Well, I think this 1 year, I'm very excited about my year that I'll be traveling. And we'll be visiting 4 continents. And I'm really happy because we'll be working forward about spreading awareness on menstrual hygiene. And I'll be joined by my other Miss World sisters. We have 6 continental queens as well. So that is what I'm excited about right now. And Bollywood is something which is not on my mind as of now. So I really can't say anything about it.
Good evening. Hi, Satish here. Heartiest congratulations.
Thank you.
The very moment you won the title, okay, after that, till now, have you managed to speak to Rita Faria, the person whom you idolized, and also Amir, the person with whom you want to make a Bollywood debut, you dream of making your debut with?
Well, when I won Miss World India, actually, I did write her an email, which I haven't gotten a reply to yet, but I hope that I'm able to go to Dublin and meet her in person, and I haven't been able to speak to either of them.
Thank you.
Manushi, this is hi.
Hi.
Priyanka from Indian Express.
Hi, Priyanka.
So, on one, congratulations, first of all. On
Thank
one
you.
Hand, we are celebrating an Indian woman's international victory. And on the other hand, we are witnessing open death threats to an actor, to an Indian woman who's already internationally recognized. So, how do you react to something like that?
I feel that there's one thing all Indian women have in common is that we don't feel persecuted of who we are, and we actually face our challenges head on. And I think that's what we need to do. We need to be confident about who we are. And definitely, there we will face a lot of limitations. And it isn't. Sometimes we do feel that it's not a very women-friendly society. But as individuals, we should just set an example and make women feel confident that you can do amazing things as well.
Thank you.
हाय मानुषी जी
हाय
सबसे पहले तो कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन जिस तरह से आपने अपना और पूरे भारत देश का नाम रोशन किया हमारे पास शब्द नहीं है कि हम आपको किन शब्दों में विश करें लेकिन ढेरों सारे सवाल है मानुषी जी आपसे पूछने के लिए सबसे पहला सवाल ये कि आपके मिस वर्ल्ड बनते ही पाकिस्तान में एक डिबेट चालू हो गई वो ये कि उनका ऐसा कहना है कि हिंदुस्तान से ज़्यादा ब्यूटीफुल लड़कियाँ पाकिस्तान में है लेकिन बुरखे में तो जब आप इस तरह की चीज़ें सुनती हैं पढ़ती हैं आपको बताया जाता है तो क्या टेक होता है आपका और क्या कहना चाहेंगी आप
मैं बस ये कहना चाहूँगी कि ये सिर्फ बाहरी सुंदरता की बात नहीं है अगर आप देखेंगे आपने अगर मिस वर्ल्ड देखा होगा तो आपने देखा होगा कि हर लड़की बहुत ही सुंदर थी पर अपनी बाहरी सुंदरता को किस तरह से आप इस्तेमाल करके आप लोगों के लिए अच्छा कर सकते हैं it's about that and it's not the most beautiful I don't think it's the most beautiful face that wins it's just that a one beautiful heart that is selected to represent those beautiful faces and it doesn't matter which country you are from to be honest it is that one person and how can you contribute to the world
हमने देखा कि आपको ऐसा प्लेटफॉर्म मिला एंड आज आप मिस वर्ल्ड हैं जो हमने ऑडियो वीडियो में भी यहाँ पर देखा जिन लड़कियों को प्लेटफॉर्म नहीं मिल पाता और वो इस तरह के प्लेटफॉर्म पर आना चाहती उनके लिए क्या टिप्स देना चाहेंगे मानुषी जी
मैं बस ये कहना चाहूँगी कि हमेशा नेवर गिव अप ऑन योर ड्रीम्स एंड यस मैं अपने आप को बहुत ही फॉर्चुनेट मानती हूँ कि मेरे पेरेंट्स ने मुझ में बिलीव करा एंड दे सपोर्टेड मी टू परस्यू माई ड्रीम्स But definitely there are girls who do face a lot of inhibitions. But just don't give up, you know. And when you have the courage to actually pursue your dreams, all good things will come to you.
And Manushi, filmen dekhti hai aap? Agar main aapse puchna chahun to.
Main kitabe zyada padhti hu waise.
Okay. And wo aisi female actor ya male actor kaun se hain jinko aap manti ki ye bahut hi beautiful hai ya aap unki filmen bahut dekhti hain agar aap bata sake hame to.
मुझे लगता है कि सारे ही एक्टर्स एंड एक्ट्रेसेस बहुत ही ब्यूटीफुल है तो मैं एक को चूज़ नहीं कर पाऊँगी बट डेफिनेटली मैं आमिर खान की मूवी में वर्क करना चाहूँगी बिकॉज आई थिंक ही हैज़ रियली चैलेंजिंग रोल्स दैट ही गिव्स टू एंड एट द सेम टाइम उनके जो मूवीज़ होती है दे हैव अ मैसेज एंड अ कनेक्ट टू द सोसाइटी सो दैट विल बी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टू डू एंड इन द एक्ट्रेसेस माई पर्सनल फेवरेट इज प्रियंका चोपड़ा
थैंक यू सो मच
थैंक यू
हाय हाय मनुजी दिस इज रवि हियर
हाय रवि
एक कहावत है विद ग्रेट पावर कम्स ग्रेट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ओके तो आपके पास जी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी अब आ गई है आपके ऊपर तो आने वाले समय में आप इन रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज़ के लिए कितनी तैयार हैं
मुझे नहीं लगता कि डेफिनेटली विद ग्रेट पावर कम्स ग्रेट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी बट I feel that when you love what you're doing, you don't feel the responsibility on your head. And I love doing this. So I'm not taking any pressure. I'm actually enjoying it.
Hi, I'm Chinmay from Sakal. I want to ask you, you have done Nagada in the competition, so what you make to do this song, except Kuchipudi, you are trained in it. So, Dances of the World is my favorite segment of the Miss World finale, because every country gets to show, every continent this year got to show their culture, and मुझे लगा कि मैं इंडिया का सेलिब्रेशन दिखाना चाहती हूँ. And everyone connects India to Bollywood, so that is why I chose Nagara. And it was a very fun song. That was the first time that I had learned a little bit of Garba. So I'm happy that I could do that. And every time in rehearsals, the song used to come up. All the girls used to stand up and dance to it. So I'm happy that in that way, I could bring India in front of the world.
Hi, Manushi. Pooja here from Hi, News Pooja. Nation channel. How was it to coming back to India? How was it watching your fans waiting for you on airport?
I think it was very overwhelming. I was counting every minute on my flight back to India. And I even troubled poor Steve, telling him 2 minutes more, 1 minute more to land. So I couldn't sleep in the last 1 hour when we had to land. And it was so overwhelming that even though we landed at midnight, people had come to receive me. And I think I felt so loved. And that's when I felt that, you know, it's a great feeling when you bring pride back to your country.
I have a question for Mrs. Julia. How has it been to be with Indians representing right from Rita Faria to Manushi Chiller? All the six ladies who have won Miss World.
If I know they all have very nice families, but I almost feel like a second mother, because when we're traveling, it's really important that there are times when they need just to be at home. And this is really important to make sure that during Manushi's year, whilst there's a lot of things to do, there's also a great need to rest down and to stop and just to be at home. So I feel that we know each other very specially on a basis of trust, love and protection. So whatever she does, whatever she says, is a special meaning for me, that it's secret, it's special, and she will be treated like, the only thing I can say, as my family, because when we're on the road and we're doing different things and seeing a lot of sadness and a lot of trauma in many kids and many women and men, I think we share sadness, but we also have all each other to share it with. So it is important to be like a family. And although we're professionals in our job, there has to be a time when you can come home, shut the door, and put your feet up and all be together and feel there's home away from home. But she will get time to be home with her family, and I really love her family. They're very supportive, they're strong and wonderful people. And I know that between us all, she'll come out unscathed, but hopefully with a lot more understanding of international needs as well as India's needs. And I know India's going to not just be proud of her now, but even more proud when you see the work she is able to do around the world.
Hi, my question is for Ms. Julia. This is Ritu Raj from Republic TV. You've been part of the organization for so many decades now. How do you feel has the setup evolved? You know, perhaps a lot of women who win it now are not necessarily from modeling background, like in her case, she has an academic background. So how have you seen this evolve over the last few decades that you've been part of?
Well, it started in 51, and it was an exercise after the war in Britain. And then it was just a bit of fun as a public relations exercise. It did move from there. When I came in, whilst I love the idea of people being free to do things, I did feel that a lot of the young women that we worked with were not necessarily comfortable walking on a stage in a bikini. And there was nothing wrong with it. I don't condemn it. I just think that if you're going to get the best of an individual, you need to make them feel comfortable. So we felt that when I took over, we didn't need to parade on stage in bikinis, but we did need to have razzmatazz and
all lots of fun. And if we wanted to do beachwear, we did it on the beach. Working with so many nations, in fact, we work with 140, and they're still growing and coming together. I think it's quite important to know that we must also realize that working around the world, we need to give everybody consideration. And there are some things in some countries that are unacceptable. So we try over across the board to be fair and to make everyone feel comfortable. And therefore, I think they show who they are as a person when they're walking on stage. They have confidence. And our job is to build that confidence and enhance it.
Good evening. This is Sumit Sharma from India TV. Manushi, praises for your efforts and thank you for making us proud.
Thank you, Sumit.
And please allow me to ask Ms. Julia first. Ms. Julia, why it took 17 years for India to win that pageant? What is your idea on this?
Well, you see, around the world there are many beautiful women, and so it happens that the juries choose different people. It just so happens that India has to know that 17 years is a long time, but many people have waited 61 years. You have to take it as it comes, and when you're ready for it, it happens, and you're surely ready for it now because you have a most beautiful winner. It is very much a jury that makes the decisions. I'm purely chairman of the judges, but they chose well this time. I haven't got an answer for the last 17 years. I can only say we have been returning in that 17 years, and we have been working with your wonderful Muktagan School in Mumbai that now have seven schools here for mothers who live in the slum areas to bring their children to school, and both study at the same time, so mothers can learn to read and write and get jobs, and the children learn to go to school and become engineers, doctors and lawyers, whatever they want to be. So I think that whilst we haven't always won in those 17 years, Miss World, we have won a lot together with your wonderful people here that have been organizing Miss India. They've done such a good job now involving the projects, and I know that everyone has been behind us to support Muktagan schools, and of course in many other parts, Hyderabad, children and police. We've always done things together and with the Hearts Hospital. So although it's 17 years gone by, we haven't left you. We still love you. And now we're very proud to bring this winner back.
Thank you. Manushi appears to be very sweet, no?
Sorry?
You appears to be very sweet.
Who does?
You.
Me?
Yeah.
yes, well, she is very sweet.
I have never been called very sweet before, but it's a lovely thing you say. I hope I don't disappoint you.
Manushi, you have met different people during this pageant. What is the perception they carry for India?
Well, during the pageant, the first week, they all thought I was a Bollywood actress. But jokes apart, I think they're all very similar, and we don't have preconceived notions about each other. When we go over there, we go with fresh minds, and there's a lot of curiosity to know each other, to know about each other's countries. And because I also went with a suitcase full of Indian food, thanks to having an Indian mother and being a vegetarian in China. I think that's how I bonded with all the other contestants, because everyone would come for food to my room. So I think that is one thing that I gave away about India. And the best part about the pageant is that even though we don't understand each other's languages, but we were there together, we were helping each other. And you understand that irrespective of all the superficial differences you have, you're all pretty much the same.
Okay, Manushi. Okay, yeah, I was asking you, what is the perception they carry for India?
What is the perception they carry for India?
Yeah.
There are no preconceived notions at all. Everyone comes with a fresh mind, and I think it's, you just look at the individual and they just want to know you. They don't have any preconceived notions.
Manushi, aisa kaun sa profession hai jiski jo salaries hai bahut tremendously high hai, par unko recalibrate karna chahiye taki jinki salaries utni high nahi hai to barabar ho jaye.
I wouldn't want to do that to any profession. I don't want any profession to, you know, to lessen their salaries, I think. But I think every profession deserves equal respect.
Okay. Tisra, Manushi, you are from Haryana. Do you think winning the pageant will encourage women over there? You will be setting an example, so they will be more motivated to come forward being from Haryana.
Absolutely. In fact, even when I won the pageant at my state, when I won Miss India Haryana, even then there were a lot of girls who would come and ask me out of curiosity and who would come and speak to me that we don't know how to go about it and we are interested in Miss India. So that's very nice that when, you know, one person from your group ventures into a new horizon, and the others are also encouraged to take that step.
Those people in Haryana are eagerly waiting you. And even the Haryana government has announced like lots of privileges for you. How you take this and will be availing those privileges?
Well, I'm very excited to go to Haryana and meet everyone, because everyone has been so kind and everyone has been very supporting. And I'm very grateful to the government of Haryana for all the privileges that they are offering to me. And one of them is of a position that I can take at a government office. And I'd really like to contribute to the Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao Andolan.
Okay. But there are certain people who might have issues. So would you like to say something to them in these regards, like giving the privileges?
Well, I am here to serve, to give back to my state, to my nation. I'm here to give whatever services I can to anyone. And I don't think anyone from Haryana or from anywhere in the world should have a problem with that.
Thank you so much, and wishing you all the best.
Thank you so much. It was really nice talking to you. Thank you.
Pleasure.
Manushi, Justin here from PTI towards your left.
Hi, Justin.
Yeah, hi, congratulations.
Thank you.
Brilliant campaign on the menstrual health.
Thank you so much. I just wanted
to ask you, is it kind of sad that on one hand, we have people like you working for this cause, but we also have the government who has levied a heavy tax on sanitary pads, which makes it probably impossible for people from the rural background or perhaps poor background to afford it. Is it kind of sad that the whole dichotomy exists in India where, on one hand, the Miss World is perhaps rooting for it, but the government is not so much?
I absolutely agree on that. That there was a quote going around that menstruation is something which is very natural, and sanitary pads are a necessity, not a luxury. So definitely, I feel that they should be available at a very low cost, so that every woman is able to afford them. And the good thing through my project that I could do was that, along with a local manufacturer of sanitary pads and Walmart India, we could actually make these pads available at a very low cost. But definitely, I would like to take this forward and be able to bring light on this, because I feel that it is necessary that sanitary pads are available at a very low cost.
Also, just out of curiosity, what were the first few hours like after you won? Because I'm sure it must have been chaotic and maddening. What is going on in your head after the first few hours? Do you recall that?
It was a mixture of emotions, the first few hours, and there was a lot of excitement, and there was everyone, all the good wishes pouring in. And there was a lot of anticipation as to what is going to happen next, what am I expected to do. But I think I was just enjoying that moment. It was still sinking in. I was trying to realize, because my family was there, they were so proud, and all my friends, like my friends from India, and everyone who came down to support me, everyone was there. And I was happy that This was my dream, but I could actually bring pride to 1.2 billion people.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hi. Manushi, you always spoken about your mother being your guardian angel and the way she has helped you shape up the way you are in your career. What role has your father played to reach wherever you are right now?
Well, my father has really respected the fact that my mother is my best friend, for first. I've always been very close to both my parents, though I'm very fond of my mother and I really want to be like her. But my father has been an amazing person in my life, because he's always believed in me. And he calls me his dragon, because he says that whatever situations you face in life, you face it with courage. So throughout the journey when I started, because I've never done pageants before, and there was a lot of
nervousness when I came, walked first into the auditions of Miss India. But I think it was my father, it was my parents who kept telling me that, yes, you can do it. So my father has been like my backbone and he's always stood by me.
Also, with your win, I think India has leveled up with Venezuela as far as the number of Miss Worlds are concerned.
Yes.
So what's your one advice for all the fellow Indians for the next year that we can become one up on Venezuela to have one more Miss World back in India?
Well, all I tell is that this is a very beautiful journey. So cherish every moment and just be yourself. You know, there's nothing else which is more beautiful when you are yourself and you're not apologetic about it.
Thank you so much.
Hi, Manuji. Sarvesh Tiwari from ETV.
Hi.
मेरा सवाल था कि जिस वक्त आपको ताज पहनाया जा रहा था, अनाउंसमेंट हुई कि आप मिस वर्ल्ड बन गई हैं, उस समय एक काफ़ी भावुक हो गई थी आप, इमोशन जीतने के बाद जब अनाउंसमेंट होगी, सबसे पहला कॉल भारत में आपने सबसे पहले किसे किया?
सबसे पहला कॉल भारत में जो हमारी मिस इंडिया टीम है, मेरा उनसे पहले सबसे पहली बात हुई थी, क्योंकि उन्होंने मुझे बहुत सपोर्ट करा है throughout. My family was already there and a lot of my supporters were right there, but the first phone call was with the Miss India organization back here, because they've really believed in me through the like the very first day when I walked into the auditions. I think they've really encouraged me and they've made me believe in my own dreams, so I think I was very grateful to them for that.
एक दूसरा सवाल था कि अभी आपके आने से पहले पर्दे पे आपके कुछ वीडियो दिखाए गए, उसमें हम तीन मानुषी को देख रहे हैं, एक जहाँ पे एक मानुषी सोशल वर्क कर रही है, दूसरी एक डॉक्टरेट फील्ड में है और तीसरी मानुषी हमारे सामने बैठी मिस वर्ल्ड है. आने वाले समय में आपका जो करियर होगा वो किस करियर में हम आपको देख सकेंगे पूरा भारत देश?
वेल, वो तीनों मानुषी एक ही है वैसे, क्योंकि अगर मैं एक डॉक्टर हूँ या फिर मैं मिस वर्ल्ड हूँ या फिर मैं अपना ब्यूटी विद अ पर्पस प्रोजेक्ट में के तरफ काम कर रही हूँ, तो तीनों का मोटिव एक ही है, टू बी एबल टू मेक अदर्स लाइव्स मोर कंफर्टेबल. सो तीनों मानुषी एक ही है और आप आगे भी मुझे इसी अवतार में देखेंगे.
करियर की बात करें, किस फील्ड में?
डॉक्टर, ऑफ कोर्स.
ओके, थैंक यू.
मानुषी जी, ट्विटर पर देखा हमने आपको ढेरों सारी बधाइयां मिली.
हाँ जी.
पीएम मोदी से लेकर प्रियंका चोपड़ा तक, लेकिन कुछ एक ऐसे भी ट्वीट आए जो कि हर्ट करने वाले थे, आपने भी पढ़ा, तो ऐसे लोगों के लिए क्या कहना चाहेंगे आप?
वेल, it's okay to have an opinion and everyone has an opinion, so that's actually all right. You know, agar 100 mein se agar do log mujhe kuch galat bhi bolte hain to mujhe 98 logon ne acha bola, so I think I'll focus on the positive side of it.
Are we ending it? Manu, Natasha,
any more questions?
You went, probably everyone would like to ask you, you were at the temple today, Siddhi Vinayak, would you like
Haan
to
ji.
Share kuch batana chahengi, your wishes, how you felt over there?
I think after coming back, it was very important for me to express my gratitude, not only to the people around me, but also to Ganpati ji. And it's very nice to go pray, to meditate and to introspect. Because after a very gruesome journey that I had, it was very tiring for all of us, and I think that was one moment I wanted to connect with myself.
Thank you, Manushri. Very impressive. Wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
As always, and in the future also, you will make us proud. We hope for this.
I hope I keep making my country proud.
Miss Julia, it will be difficult for us to wait another 17 years, so we want this to be regular, on regular basis.
We'll have to wait and see.
Okay. And you also, aate jaate raha karo aap, jara. We get to see you and see your sweet face.
Thank you. He's saying that you should keep coming back and visiting us.
I'd love to do that. Thank you.
Yeah, yeah. Miss India ka grand finale hua kar. Oh, sorry, Hindi mein ja raha hu main. Whenever there is a grand finale of Miss India, please come down here. We get to see your lovely face.
I'm going to be with Natasha, and she is going to take us on her journey across India when she is looking for the next Miss World, and we're looking at projects at the same time. So you haven't got rid of me yet.
Thank you so much.
I want you to adopt me.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, thank you so much, members of the media. One question? Go ahead, ask. Can we get a mic here for the last question, please, right in the front seat? For Priyanka in the front. Okay, one last question for Mrs. Morley. There's one question for you, one last one, if that's okay. There you go.
Hi, Mrs. Morley. Hi, this is Priyanka.
Hi.
Mrs. Morley, you are an inspiration to not just Indians, but people all over the world. We want to know, what was the inspiration behind Beauty with a Purpose?
It's an interesting question. In 1972, I was in Singapore, and I was watching an old lady from my hotel room. She was on the road. In those days, Singapore wasn't quite like it is today. It was very simple and very poor. They didn't have the big airport. Changi Prison actually had a little place next door for children who were mentally unwell, and they were living like, well, they didn't have to, had to have some air, so they had like a prison front with bars, and they were trying their best to do things. And I looked out of my hotel window one morning, and there was an old lady washing some of the children on the street. They were children who perhaps couldn't move very much, and she, every morning, I would wake up and look out the window for her. And around 6:30, she was cleaning faces, giving food, doing the sweetest things. And every day for 2 weeks, she was doing this. And I went down one morning to speak to her. And it shows my ignorance, but I said to her, "Don't you ever get tired of doing this?" And she looked at me. She wasn't angry. She smiled and she said, "Is it not better to light one candle in the darkness than not to see at all?" And from that moment, I felt this was really a message for me, to listen, to learn, and to be humble about this wonderful lady. And I wanted to make Miss World, working with it, have a purpose. And Beauty with a Purpose was born that day. And I was in Singapore, and all the girls in the Miss Singapore contest adopted that very day Beauty with a Purpose. We were, in fact, I had been working a lot with children, and we had several children from Singapore and Malaysia come to London, and I had them in my home, helping them to recover from cancer and heart surgeries. We had two for heart surgery, and I'd take them home and then take them back. So although we did it in a smaller way, in 72 it started, and now every country is involved, and each country tries their best to do a project and to use young women and men, because Mr. World does the same. Young men and women across the world are looking to do something useful in their country. Now it's getting bigger, their organizations get behind them. But you know, to help one person, as this old lady did, one person can light that one candle than not to see in the darkness, is something that really hit my heart. And I believe that that's what I was meant to do all my life. And now I'm over 21. I feel that I wake up in the morning and it's so exciting, because the day brings so many blessings. Like this today, it's a blessing. So, you know, that's how I feel. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Morley. That is indeed extremely inspiring for all of us. You teach us a lot in life. Thank you. Can we please have both of you right in front for a picture opportunity?